Right, how would you evaluate CJ? He just physically looked like that week of rest seemed to help him.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought it showed during the week. And who knows, maybe give him a little perspective too, watching the game last week, watching meetings, watching practice. We'll see, you know, but he did play better tonight, and still a lot of football ahead of us, but it was encouraging to see him play the way he did.
Right next door, Bill?
Ryan, on the near interception that CJ threw, it looked like you were telling him you wanted him to come back to Jeremy there on that in-breaking route over the number one at him. And then he comes back and he throws a touchdown to Chris on the next play. I'm just wondering how you coach that, because, I mean, he made a mistake, and then he made it one of the better plays he's made all year. So, how do you balance that?
Yeah, without getting into too many specifics, that was not the right read. But then he came back, and I thought he showed some toughness. And our message all week has been toughness. And, you know, how does a quarterback show toughness? You know, he avoids a rush and then makes a play like that. I thought there were times where, you know, we were down on the goal line there, and the ball popped out. You know, it's the first time we've really got a live ball on the 1 yard line for Luke Whippler, the quarterback, for everybody. He kind of salvaged that and you know, got back on the ball, and then he took a hit on the touchdown pass to Jeremy Rucker. And so I thought there was some toughness shown there, which was good. But overall, I thought our team played with more toughness than they have in the past. And this was an important game for us because I felt like, you know, September 2nd, a month ago, you know, when we played Minnesota, we were a much different team, and I felt like that going into this week. But we hadn't shown it yet, and I felt like we saw some glimpses of that tonight.
Bill Rabinowitz?
Does this feel like the first time this year that you look the way you expect an Ohio State team to look?
Yes. But I also think that when you look at Ronnie Hickman, you look at Cam Martinez, when you look at Jackson Smith Ajigba, C.J. Stroud, Travion Henderson, some of these guys, Cody Simon, Tommy Eichenberg, these are all guys who had zero starts in their entire career. Well, they're not young anymore. Now they have you know, five games under their belt, so that they're not young anymore. They're not inexperienced. They do have games under their belt. So now we know what to expect. We also know, you know, what guys can give us meaningful minutes behind them, and then who needs to continue to work hard to get to where they need to be to become a contributor and create a role for themselves. We just didn't have that last year. You know, a game like this allows a bunch of guys to get on the field and all meaningful stuff. Clay?
Both of your Big Ten wins are on the road. Do you feel like you have a leg up in that sense?
It's good to get those two wins for sure, yeah. You know, with a young team, the way that this first half of the schedule played out, which is what it was, we had to handle it. I think it made it strong. Made it stronger. I think that it has. You know, going on the road and you know, obviously you know, handling a loss, you know, in second game of the year and those type of things have made us stronger. And I think we can continue to build on this. That's been the whole goal. Is if we just get better week in and week out, continue to get these guys reps, keep coaching better, and giving our guys the better opportunity to be successful, then hopefully we, you know, pick our head up here in about a month where we need to be going into November.
All right, behind him, Nathan Baird.
You kind of transitioned from just looking for defensive players who could, you know, get the job done to now you got these young guys who are out there actually making plays, and what Denzel did. How is that sort of changing just, I guess, the whole vibe around the team, the confidence the whole team has?
Yeah, I think you can see that. I mean, yeah, it's just a bunch of guys who are now maybe expecting to make plays. Before, you know, I don't think they really were just trying to get lined up, and everything they were doing was for the first time. So I thought the defensive staff did a good job this week with the plan. I thought they fixed up the looks. I thought we created disruption in the backfield, and then we were able to create some turnovers. But you know, you have to play well early in conference games like this, especially on the road, to hopefully take the crowd out of it. And I thought the play that Cam Martinez made was a big play, and then a couple plays later we scored the touchdown with Travion, and that kind of got us going. Obviously, the pick by Denzel was big. You know, overall though, the special teams, you know, Greg does a great job, excuse me, with special teams. And so Parker Fleming, I thought, had a really good week of work preparation-wise. Got our guys locked in, and you know, overall, we're prepared to play this game on special teams. So I hats off to him and the guys. And Cam showed up in that spot right there, which was big.
Right there in the front row, Dan Holt.
Yeah, Ryan, you had said a couple weeks ago, and people were asking a lot of questions about the quarterbacks, but what you had seen from CJ in practice and how that gave you a lot of confidence in him. Was what we saw from CJ today more of what you had seen from CJ in practice?
Yeah, I would say so. This is what he's capable of. And now he's got to bring it, though. He's got to be consistent. Still a lot of things you're going to watch on film tomorrow. We've got to get corrected. We've got to get fixed. And, you know, we've got to come back and do it again next week because now, you know, there's a body of work on film. So now guys are going to look at him and try to attack him different ways. And he's going to have answers. And that's playing in the Big Ten. So, but you can see what he's capable of.
Clay Hall?
Mitch Rossi, did you make him a star today?
Mitch, Mitch has done nothing but everything we've asked him to do. I mean, he's a very tough young man. He works really, really hard, and you know, he deserves everything that he's getting, because you know, he's the quarterback of the punt team. He does all those jobs. You know, he will play fullback in the goal line and those types of things.
Yeah.
All those thankless jobs. And I'm glad we have him. He's you know, one of the more reliable guys on our team. And it's good to see some of those tight ends, you know, get some touches. Jeremy had a nice day coming back home, which was great, getting a touchdown. And I also thought it was really good to see all the receivers get, you know, get their hands on some balls as well. You know, Chris Olave, I think, tied Chris Carter today with touchdown catches. You know, he didn't really get the ball much the last couple of weeks. He stayed with it. You know, that's not easy. You know, we're not getting touches like that. And didn't play much in the second half, but when he was in there, you know, he made an impact, which was great. And saw some other guys make some plays, but it was good to see Mitch get in there and make a couple plays for us.
Second row, Rob Aller.
Travion looked like he got dinged. Well, what's the update there? And he's such a difference maker. Can you just talk about what he does for the offense that maybe not that the other guys don't, but he's a separator.
Well, yeah. I mean, he's got a different skill set than the other guys. I do think Master ran hard again today. Marcus Crowley ran hard today, but you can see the home run ability for Trey. He's still young, still learning, but he does have a ton of home run ability. It was my decision to hold him out in the second half. He was ready to go. I just felt like I didn't want to take a chance in that second.
Over here, Steven Means.
Brian, again with CJ, whether it was maybe the week off with the shoulder, just maybe some of the play calls you were calling, just, you know, spreading the ball out. He just seemed more comfortable out there and more like, he looked like a quarterback one day. And was that the kind of the assessment you got, just fresh off the game with him?
I mean, I think it was the most comfortable he's looked, but at the same time, he's still really, really young. Still green in this whole thing. And he's got a lot of football ahead of him. He's going to have good times and good plays and bad plays. But he didn't, like you said, he didn't get rattled. Like, you know, he had a couple plays that maybe didn't go his way, but then he came right back and continued to make plays. But I think it really goes to the preparation we had this week. And, you know, he's got good players around him. He's got a good offensive line. These guys did a good job of giving him time back there. He wasn't really pressured all that much. And the receivers made big plays. You know, even the one catch, you know, I think it was the first play of the drive. Chris, you know, catching the ball and kind of toe taps on the sideline. An unbelievable play. And then that gets us going. Those are the kind of things that help a quarterback when he tries to get, you know, his rhythm going.
That exact play where he's rolling out and kind of wide something. Was he doing that? Have you seen that progression without those types of plays where things maybe aren't off schedule?
Yeah, and the touchdown to Chris on the other one, that was an off, like you said, off schedule play. You know, he kind of created and worked the second part of the route, and that's good. And that's part of the game. And I think, this is probably the best game he's done that.
And we've got time for just a couple more. Tony Gerdman?
Ryan, aside from the getting better physically, how did you see CJ put that week off to use? How did you see him grow?
Yeah, okay. I don't know. I think that he's more healthy, and he came in really, really well prepared. And the guys around him helped him too. But and you know, when the defense is playing the way it is, and you know, you just play with more confidence. And I thought we played better team football today, but again, maybe it gave him a little bit of perspective coming back. I don't know, but good preparation this week.
And final question, Rob, go ahead.
How much is patience a part of this, both as a coaching staff, even just, I mean, you guys kind of maybe unfairly were like off the rails early, but did you see that as a fair assessment? And is patience part of it as a coaching staff?
Well, in an area where patience is not allowed, you know, and I think that, but I understand that and I know that. And, you know, a bunch of talks with a lot of people, and one of them, Gene Smith, and he said just that right there. You know, you have to be patient. You have to continue to, you know, work some of these younger guys in, and this is a unique team, and you have to, you know, we're doing things the right way, and we know that. We're recruiting great people. You know, we're a first-class operation, always do things the right way, and, you know, there's times where you have to grow through some growing pains along the way, and we're not going to panic. Certainly, we have to act when appropriate, but we're not going to overreact, and we just continue to get better, and that's the plan here. When you're doing that, then you know you can go put your head on your pillow at night, knowing you're doing the right things. And having a win like this, you know, of the last month, it's given us a little bit of juice now as we head into the next month of October. Like, okay, there was some tough times here, but we grew through it. We didn't panic, and now we might have a good team as we head into the, you know, into October and November. Great.